Hello, I'm Dr. Sherman Leis. I'm board certified in general surgery and plastic and reconstructive surgery, and I specialize in surgery for transgender people. I'm the founder and chief surgeon at the Philadelphia Center for Transgender Surgery. You can visit our website at www.thetransgendercenter.com, or if you want an answer to some immediate questions, you could call our office and speak to one of our knowledgeable staff at 610-667-1888. Today I'd like to talk to you a little bit about the history of transgender surgery. You know, transgender surgery, even though it's just recently been in the media the last few years, it's really been around for centuries. In ancient Greek and Roman times, there were transsexual patients that transitioned from male to female. Mainly, they cross-dressed. They presented as the females, and they did basic, rather crude surgeries, mainly amputation of male body parts in order to look more female. The surgery wasn't very sophisticated, and of course, in those days, they didn't have anesthesia. They would give somebody a bottle of wine or whiskey to drink, or use some natural herbs, which were types of narcotics, and then just did the surgery. It wasn't very pleasant. But the biggest change in transgender surgery, even though it was done for centuries and in many countries around the world, came in the 1950s, where a surgeon from France, whose name was Dr. Georges Bourreau, who lived and practiced medicine in Casablanca, Morocco, had a clinic there where he did sex change operations, genital reassignment operations, and people came from all over the world. It was the place to go to in the world if you wanted to have sex change surgery. And he was very popular, he was very well known, and he was the first person to do, and he did mainly male to female surgery, to do the penile inversion technique. And there wasn't much else to it. He amputated, removed the testicles, removed the erectile tissues of the penis, and inverted the penile skin to use as a lining for the vagina. Later in the 1950s, when Harry Benjamin in New York, an endocrinologist in New York, started studying and working with transgender patients and was the first legitimate doctor to treat transgender patients with hormones, he would also recommend patients for surgery. And at that time, there were only a couple of places you could go to have legitimate surgery in the United States. One was Johns Hopkins in the 1960s, Johns Hopkins University in Baltimore, Maryland, Stanford University Hospital in California. They were the two biggest and best known places. And then, also in the 1960s, in Trinidad, Colorado, a doctor by the name of Stanley Biber, a general surgeon in a very small town in Trinidad, Colorado, did a male-to-female surgery on a patient that just asked him if he could do it, who lived in the area. And he said, sure, I'll do it, although he didn't know how to do it. He made a couple phone calls to the people at Stanford and Johns Hopkins and said, how do you do this surgery? And they gave him a brief outline, and he just went ahead and did it. He was a brave guy. He did it, but as he then that person spoke to some friends, and more people came to Trinidad, and he was very inexpensive, and he got better and better at what he did. So Trinidad, Colorado became the sex change capital of the world, and Dr. Stanley Biber did more than 6,000 gender reassignment surgeries in Trinidad, Colorado. He retired just a few years ago at age 80, and unfortunately, he died a couple of years after that. There are altogether about five or six surgeons who really specialize and do transgender surgery on a regular basis. When I began specializing in transgender surgery several years ago, I had a vision that it would be great to have one place where a transgender patient could come to and have all their needs taken care of, from hormones to cosmetics to fashion and hair, clothing consultations, all skin care, and all the different types of surgery that we do. So I thought, if we could put all this together under one roof, if we can have a group of people who specialize in all of these areas, many of them are here in our offices and others are in our immediate area, this could be a great service to the trans community. And that's what we created. I have offices with overnight facilities in the same building. We have an office staff who are very knowledgeable. We have estheticians who specialize in makeovers and give you a makeover before you leave. And we have a large staff now of about 40 specialists in mental health, licensed clinical social workers, psychologists, psychiatrists, several endocrinologists, gynecologists, gynecologic endocrinologists, lawyers, hair removal experts, electrolysis and laser hair removal. We do that right here at our center. All of these specialties we have on our professional team, and we make these connections for you. We can arrange consultations for you. We can arrange even other surgeries. So we offer many services under one roof, and we do them all with great sensitivity and great compassion for our patients. We really live in the transgender world, and we can give you references to speak to many of our patients who will tell you how well they're cared for here. And that's why people come from not only all around the United States and Canada, but from really all around the world. Well, I feel I've really found the niche in my life. It makes me happy to know that I've made someone else happy and that I've helped create a life for someone. If plastic surgery is all about making people and helping people feel better about themselves, that's nowhere more true than in the field of transgender surgery. Makes me feel good when I go to sleep every night that I know I've helped someone that day live the life that they want to live.